sex or the song? Sex is, nobody knows. But the saw is family.
All right, guys, Witchdoctor Productions, Aborted Tour 2015. Swear. Yeah. It's been a few months since you played Witchfest, guys. Yeah. What's been happening?
We did a whole bunch of summer festivals in Europe, and we've been writing for a new album. We just recorded a new EP, and we'll be out by the end of the year.
All right. And what's been driving that writing process, man? What's the joke to your mind?
I don't know, man. Fecal matter, hatred for mankind, and popsicles.
All right, sure, man. So your experience at Witchfest, tell us about it, man. What went through your mind when you played Africa for the first time?
It was fantastic. We had no idea what to expect to play. I didn't think anybody knew us. But, you know, when we started playing, I guess we started getting into it. So it was a really, really fun show. And afterwards, we got drunk quicker, but it was a great experience.
Well, clearly the fact that you guys are back means much more.
They're posing, right?
Yeah.
You're like, fuck these guys again? What the hell?
No, man.
Moving from the big venue of 10,000 plus and being forced into a 1,200 venue with the lineup we had, it was a financial nightmare from day one. It was never going to make money. It was never even going to come close to breaking even, you know. So, but at the same time, you know, we made an executive decision that if we cancelled that event because of what was happening, we would be losing the bigger battle in the long run, you know. No one's going to ever believe in metal if it keeps cancelling or keeps getting pushed around. So we pushed through that, you know. And we delivered, got the bands there, put on three of the best days of music the country's ever seen, I think, in metal, you know. So a lot of work, a lot of hours, you know. Plus we made our struggle public. We told everyone what was going on. They could see. I mean, they know I lost my house, I've lost my car, I've lost everything I own just to pay for that festival, you know. So,
and you keep doing it.
I keep doing it because I'm not doing it for money. You know? If I was doing it for money, I'd be doing something. My accountant will tell you straight around, the biggest idiot he's ever met in his life. Keeps telling me, stop doing what you're doing, man.
Yeah.
But it's not for that, you know. It's like when you stand, like tonight when Aborted plays, and you stand to the side and look at the people, that's why.
Come back.
also don't realize is that when these guys play, they're playing to people who've seen a thousand bands every day of their life. They're kind of, whatever. But you come here, it's the first, I always tell them, it's a virgin crowd. It's the first time. It's like your, it's the ultimate gig, really, because it's the first time they've ever seen your band live, ever, in 20 years, you know? You don't get that in the rest of the world. The whole crowd, where everybody in the venue has never seen you. There's maybe 10 or 20. But this is the only country when you come here for the first time, nobody's ever seen you.
Yeah.
You know, so it's like, there's a different kind of energy, you know? Yeah. There really is a different kind of energy to those gigs and like the European gigs where the people have seen them relentlessly all the time. They kind of take it in their stride, you know?
Yeah.
So the South African audience compared to where you guys play all over the world, you know, how would you say you experience them compared to the rest of the world?
Hungry. Yeah. I mean, I'm assuming you don't get international bands from the fucking time. So many crowds. People are actually excited. As to where, like, some of the major cities in Europe, people are very jaded because they get a tour every week, so they don't care. So here, actually, you know, it's like it's just a bunch of people.
Well, I can tell you right now, man, there's a bunch of hungry motherfuckers out there, and it's in the beautiful Clinton city of Cape Town.
You do an event, and the guys will make more money at the bar ever with the metal crowd. But then they will come and offer stuff, and I turn it down on principle because to me, they what they're telling me is that these people are worthless to them, so take what I'm offering to them. And I don't feel that. I feel that metalheads in general are your strongest brand supporters. So if I'm going to allow a brand into my shows and the metal scene, they must be there for the long run,
yeah,
for the full distance, and they must also add some value for some local bands down the line. Not just going to come in and put your posters up and give us 12 cases of your energy drink.
Yeah.
Go away, you know, because that doesn't add value, you don't build the scene, but it looks like your event, you know? So we need to get some guys who are serious that want to get involved, you know, so that we can take it in. Because the biggest, my number one goal that I have is I'm trying to get the ticket prices down.
Yeah.
That's what I have to do, because the rent keeps moving, the shit keeps going up, makes it really difficult. So I need to get some people involved in the scene, but I want the right people who are there for a 3 to 5 year plan, not just for one show and then I've got to lick their ass for another show. I want some guys who want to work long term on growing something.
Right? Yeah. Cool.
Sean,
as always, Sean, as always. That's
good.
I'll listen. Fucking rock on, guys.
Expect
it. Brutality.
There we go, man.
There you go.
Good. Thank you. We look forward to seeing you on stage, ripping it up, Aborted again. Fucking A, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, enjoy it.